Hello friends, here is a summary of scoped storage, and here you can see that all the apps have their own private app storage which is accessible only by the app, and if other apps have to access files in the private app storage then it requires a file provider. And then there is a shared storage which includes the downloads folder and the media folder containing photos, videos and music or audio library. So this downloads folder can be accessed. You can add any file to this downloads folder without any permission, and you can add any file to this media store without any permission. But if you have to modify any file in the media store, or if you have to delete any file in the media store, then you need the media permission to access the media files. And for other files which are not in media store and not in downloads, you need special app access, or you can say storage access framework. So now in this video I will show you how to create a text file in private app storage and how to access all the files in private app storage. So here is the app which I have created, and you can see this is the front page. Here I have a text view and I can write anything in this text view, like my name is Sanjeev. Okay, so this is the text, and I can enter a file name. It will be sanjeev.txt, and then I can click on save file. So when I click on save file, it will be saved to the private app storage, and this is a button which takes me to private storage. And when I click on this, here I can see all the files in this private app storage. It contains these three files and it includes sanjeev.txt. And here when I click on this image, it shows three options: open, save and delete. When I click on open, I can open it using HTML viewer, and here you can see my name is Sanjeev. Okay, and there is this other option of share. It can be shared using all these apps. And then there is this delete option. When I click on this, the file is deleted. Okay, so let's go to the app. Let's go to the project in Android Studio. So here is the project. First thing is activity main.xml. In activity main.xml, here I have added an edit text 1. Here you can see this is edit text 1. This is for writing the text. Then there is edit text 2. This is for writing the file name. And then there is text view 1, for which the text is .txt. Okay, this file name will not include .txt, and that's why in the end I have written .txt. And then there is button 1. This is for saving the text as text file. And there is button 2. This is for moving to the next activity, which is the private storage activity. Okay, so this is activity main.xml, and in main activity it extends app compat activity, and at the top I have declared edit text 1 and edit text 2. In onCreate I have set content view to activity main, and I have defined button 1 and button 2 using their IDs, and edit text 1 and edit text 2 using their IDs. Then there is onClick listener for button 1. Okay, it is twice. I can remove this. Now there is onClick listener for button 1. And when button 1 is clicked, I save the text as a text file. So first I define a string called folder, and this is get external files directory type null dot get absolute path plus slash. So this will be the private app storage where I will be saving my file. Okay, this is the folder get external files directory type null dot get absolute path plus slash. This is the folder. Then I define a string file name equal to new file dot txt, and if edit text 2 dot get text dot to string equals empty. Okay, actually this symbol is not. So if not edit text 2 dot get text dot to string dot equals empty. So if the file name or text in edit text 2 is not empty, then I set this file name to edit text 2 dot get text dot to string plus dot txt. So the text in edit text 2 plus dot txt will be the file name. And then I define a file called new file. This is equal to new file folder comma file name. So it will create a file with this file name in this folder. Okay, so this is our file, and now we have to write our text in the file. So first I define a string variable called text, and this is equal to edit text 1 dot get text dot to string. So this is the text in edit text 1. Now I have to write this text in this file, which is new file. So for which this is the code. Okay, this is a very simple code, and actually it is missing the catch exception. Yeah, here is the catch exception. So now you can see, first in this try catch exception code, first I define a file writer called my writer. This is equal to new file writer, new file. Okay, so it creates a new file writer for this file. And then using this file writer, it writes the text. My writer.write text, which is this one. And then it closes the my writer, and then it toasts successfully wrote to the file. Okay, so only these three lines are enough to write this text in this file. And if there is any exception, I display the exception in string form as a toast message. Okay, and then there is this button to click on click listener. Here I use intent to move to private storage dot class. Okay, private storage is a new Java file. This is private storage, and I will come to this later. So I use intent to move to private storage dot class when button 2 is clicked. That's all in main activity. Now after this, we move to the private storage. I hope you understood how to save a file in private storage. It is very simple. We have to access get external files directory dot get absolute path plus slash, and in this we have to add our file. Now here I have created a new file, new layout file called private storage dot xml, and this contains only a recycler view with id recycler view 1. And there is also a file called recycler item.xml. And this contains text view 1. This is for displaying the file name. And it contains image view 1. This is the menu button. And it contains this text view 2. This is for displaying the file path. Now in private storage, here You can see I have declared a recycler view at the top, and I have declared a file array, means a list of file called all files, and I have declared a custom adapter called M adapter. In on create, I set content view to private storage, which contains a recycler view. It contains this recycler view. Then I define this M recycler view here as find view by ID r.id.recyclerView1. Next, I set the layout manager for this recycler view. M layout manager equal to new linear layout manager this. So the layout manager is linear layout manager, and I set this as the layout manager of recycler view. M recycler view dot set layout manager M layout manager. So this means it will be of a vertical list type. It will not be grid view type. Next is I add the divider item decoration. Add item decoration, new divider item decoration, get application context. So this code is for adding a divider in the recycler view. Okay, and then I refresh the adapter. So refresh adapter means I get the files to this list called all files, and then I define a new custom adapter using this, and I set it as adapter of M recycler. So here first I define a string called folder, which is equal to get external files directory null dot get absolute path plus slash. So you can see that this is the same folder which I had defined in main activity here. Now after this, I convert this folder into a file called directory. This is equal to, so I convert this string into a file called directory equal to new file folder. I can remove this. Okay, new file folder, and then this I set this all files to directory.list files. So this directory.list files will get all the files in this directory, in this folder called directory, and that will be set to this file list called all files. Here at the top, I have this file array or file list called all files, and this is set to all the files in this directory. And then I define M adapter is new custom adapter all files, and I set it as adapter of M recycler view. Now we'll have a look at the custom adapter. It extends recycler view adapter custom adapter dot view holder, and here also I have declared a file list or file array called files underscore list, and this is the constructor custom adapter file array data set, where I set this files list to this data set. Okay, so here you in the constructor you can see that I have defined it as new custom adapter all files, which is a file array. So this all files you can consider it as data set, and in this adapter this data set, or here in this case all files, will be equal to files list. Okay, this files list is set as data set. Then I set the item count. There is this get item count method where it returns files list, which is this one dot length, means number of items in this files list. Next method is the class view holder, which extends recycler view dot view holder, and this can come to this later. And next one is on create view holder. So this is public view holder, on create view holder, And since this is a view holder, and view holder class is defined here, we will see this first. So this is a class which extends recycler view dot view holder, and it contains a method public view holder view v with super v. Now inside this I have declared a text view, text view 1, text view 2, and image view, which is image view. And text view 1 is defined as v, this view v dot find view by id r dot id dot text view 1. And similarly text view 2 and this image view is defined using their ids. Now on create view holder, here I define view using layout inflator by inflating r dot layout dot recycler underscore item. Okay, this is recycler underscore item dot xml, and it contains this text view 1, text view 2, and this one image view 1. So now you can see that in this class view holder, these text view 1, text view 2, and image view are defined using the IDs text view 1, text view 2, and image view 1. Okay, and this onCreate view holder returns new view holder V with this view V. Next is onBind view holder, where we can get the position and the view holder. So here I define a string called file path to files list position. I get the item at this position of files list, and that will be a file. So I convert it to string by writing dot get absolute path. So this will be the file path in string form. Next I get the file name from this file path using its last index. So here from file path I get the last index of this symbol slash plus 1. I add 1 to that last index, and then I get that substring, file path dot substring, this thing. So this will give me the file name. Now from view holder I get text view 1, and in that I display the file name, and in text view 2 of view holder I display the file path. This text view 1 and text view 2 of view holder you can find here. This is the text view 1 and text view 2 of view holder. And next is the image view. For image view I set an on click listener, and here I define a pop-up menu, which is defined here, pop-up menu. Then I define a menu which is pop-up dot get menu. And to this menu I add three items, open, share, and delete. And then I set on click listener for this pop-up menu. And here I have a switch, item.getTitle.toString, means that it will get the title and that will be a switch. So here the first case is open, and in this case I use intent to open the file. So first this is the file, files list position, and the code used to open this now you can see the complete code which is used to open this. So I define an intent with action view and add flag grant read URI permission, and set data type to, here I use file provider to get URI of the file, comma text slash star, this is the type of the file, and then I start this intent, and this is put in a try catch exception block, and if there is activity not find exception I toast no app found to open this file. So here I've used file provider, and now I will show you how to add a file provider. So for adding file provider, you have to go to androidmanifest.xml. And here, inside the application tag, you have to add this provider with name as androidx.core.content.fileprovider and authorities. This will be your package name. This is the package name of your app, followed by dot provider. Package name followed by dot provider. Then exported equal to false and grant URI permissions equal to true. Then there is this metadata with name android.support.fileproviderpaths and resource at XML provider underscore paths. This provider underscore paths is an XML file in XML folder in resources. So next is this resource folder. In this resource folder, you have to add XML folder. So here you have to just right click, click on new, click on folder and select XML resource folder here. Okay, that will add the XML folder. In this XML folder, you have to add this XML file provider underscore paths dot XML. And in this file, add paths at the tag paths, and inside this add external dash path name equal to external underscore files path equal to dot. So this is required in provider underscore paths dot XML, and this is required for adding a file provider in your app. Now let's go back to private storage. So this is the code for opening the file. Now the code for sharing the file also uses a file provider. It uses an intent with action send and type text slash tar. And here to intent, I put extra intent dot extra stream comma the URI of file, which is file provider dot get URI for file. This is the context, private storage dot this comma, this is the authority, get application context dot get package name plus dot provider comma the file path or the file, which is files underscore list position. And then I start activity with intent dot create user intent comma title send to. So this is the code for sharing the file. Next is for deleting the file. So deleting the file, we use files underscore list position. This is the file dot delete. We only have to add dot delete. And here I have put it in if block, if file underscore list position dot delete, refresh adapter. Okay, and then in the end there is popup dot show. Now I will show you this refresh adapter. I have already shown you this refresh adapter, but let's have a look at this once again. So in refresh adapter, I get the directory, then I get all files in the external files directory to this file list called all files. Then I create a new custom adapter using this all files and set it as adapter of mRecycler. So that's all in this video. I have already shown you the app. Thank you very much for watching this.